वेलकम बैक टू आवर क्लासेस. दिस इज स्टैंडर्ड 4 जनरल साइंस. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड लेसन 4. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड लेसन 4 क्रिपी क्रोलीज अप टू द क्रोल एंड स्लाइड्स. सो टुडे वील रीड अबाउट द सोशल इंसेक्ट. Social insects are insects that live in colonies. So, the insects, those are live in colonies. They live together. That means many insects who lives in a colony, who lives together, that are known as social insects. They usually have a queen who is the most important being in the colony. In our home, our mother plays a very important role. Similarly, among the social insects, they have a queen who is the most important being in the colony. The queen is the only one that lays eggs. So, in their colonies, the queen is the only one who lays eggs that makes her very important in me. That is why the queen is the most important being in the colony. Bees, wasps and ants are the most known among the social insects. So these are the examples of the social insects. One by one, we'll read about them. So first, we'll read about the bees. Okay, bees. Honey bees make honey and build hives. So they make honey, they produce honey and build hives where the leaves, that is known as hives. Nearly 50,000 to 80,000 bees live together. So in their hive, nearly about 50,000 to 80,000 bees live together. Only one queen bee lays all the eggs. So all the eggs are laid by the queen bee. Honey bees are greatly valued for their honey. So as we know that honey is the most important food item, or we can say syrup. That is why honey bees are greatly valued for their honey. Many people make a living out of selling this honey. So many people, what they do, they just sell the honey and earn money from them. Then we'll read about the wasp. Wasps are yellow in color. They eat wood and make paper-like nests using their saliva mixed in wood paper. So wasps are generally yellow in color and they eat wood and they make their nest by using their saliva mixed with the wood. They lay their eggs in this nest. So in the nest they lay their egg. Adult wasp feed on the nectar of flowers. So adult wasp feed on the nectar of flowers. Then ants. Ants are different from flying insects like bees, and yet they behave in a similar way. So ants are ants don't fly. Then also they are in the category of the social insects, as they behave like the other social insects. We only see worker ant hurrying around to gather food for the underground nest. Ants work very hard to store food for winter and to feed the larva in their nest. So what they do, they work very hard to store their food, especially for the winter and the rainy season, and they to feed the larva in their nest. Larva means the newborn. The newborn ant is known as the larva. Okay, so for them they store the food. Then insects seen at night. So at night we see crickets and cockroaches. So these are the two insects especially we can see at night. Crickets are closely related to grasshoppers. They make a sharp chirp sound. So when they fly, they make a sound, chirrup sound, that is. Then if we don't keep food covered, cockroaches may get into food container. So this is one type of cockroach is also the example of the social insects. And if we don't cover our food, then they may get into the container, and they can cause also diseases because they travel inside the drain. As they travel inside the drain, they can also cause diseases. Then sucking blood, the insects who suck blood from the animals. So mosquitoes, leeches and bed bugs suck blood to survive. So these are the insects who suck blood to survive. Mosquitoes, we know. Leeches, leeches are the aquatic animals who live in the water, and bed bugs, especially we can found them in the bed. Okay, for that is that they are known as bed bugs. Suck blood to survive. Very small creatures like lice and dog ticks also suck blood to survive. So these are also the small creatures who can also suck blood to survive. To keep them away from us and our pets, we should make sure that we bath ourselves and our pet regularly. So if we will take bath regularly and by and to our pets also, then we may away from them. Then flea powder and tick powder help to keep fleas and ticks away from dogs. So if we'll apply this powder, then we can keep away from the fleas and the ticks from us or from our animals. So children, we have covered the lesson, and in the next lesson I will give you the question answer of this lesson. So till then, read well, and your homework is to do the number A number, B number, and this one you can do it in the book. Okay, in the next class I will give you the question answer. Till then, bye bye.